Bertie Armstrong explained what Britain needs to do so fishermen can take advantage of leaving the European Union, speaking on BBC's Any Questions. Mr. Armstrong warned the European Union the UK could be kind or unkind to future EU member states if Brexit negotiations do not go well. Mr. Armstrong suggested that Britain could punish EU member states by limiting their access to UK waters after ties with Brussels are cut. He said, "We have been recommending for practical purposes a 9-month bridge." Getty Brexit News. Bertie Armstrong explained how fishermen will thrive after Brexit. "We deliberately called it something different from a traditional period, a 9-month bridge, because the catching opportunity for the year of 2019, the whole of 2019 will be set this year while we are still in Europe. Come the 29th of March, we will become a coastal state. At the end of that year, there will be a series of negotiations where we will be in charge of our own affairs. The important part about taking charge on the moment of Brexit means we can be as kind or as unkind as we like, depending on how the negotiations go. That is the prize, what we describe as the sea of opportunity when we normalize the governance of our waters." Bertie Armstrong. Mr. Armstrong also explained exactly how British fishermen will be able to take advantage of the sea of opportunity after Brexit. He said, "We have received in the United Kingdom the roughest of rough deals from the Common Fisheries Policy on fishing. With that I mean the amount of, if you like, resource that grows in our farm that we are allowed to farm ourselves is very small. From our waters, 60% of the fish that leave do so in the beneficial hands of other EU fishing nations than the UK. We keep 40%, 60% goes to the neighbours. That was a political settlement way back in the 1970s when we joined the EC. Mon March 20, 2017. Comparative figures for large coastal states in the Northeast Atlantic are: Iceland keeps 90% of the fish that grow in its exclusive zone, and the comparative figure in Norway is they keep everything but 16%. That is the prize, what we describe as the sea of opportunity when we normalize the governance of our waters. And it is not a take back, and it is not a negotiation. When we normalize the governance of our waters, we will be able to move towards a position where we harvest what grows on our farm rather than give it away. It is unclear whether Britain will make concessions over its waters in the transitional agreement. Brussels officials have suggested they want Britain's territorial waters to remain effectively within the EU's common fisheries policy during the proposed implementation period following Brexit. Analysis from the Treasury earlier last week also suggested Britain's fishing industry will be better off outside the EU, whatever happens in the Brexit negotiations.